Welcome to Keto on the Couch with Rachel and Joe.
I'm Rachel.
And I'm Joe.
And we're Two Crazy Ketos.
If you're new to our channel, welcome.
Yes, welcome to the more than 250 new subscribers since the last Keto on the Couch.
Now here on Two Crazy Ketos, we do different things like product reviews, we do recipe videos, we talk about various keto topics, and then every Monday, we sit down on the couch for Keto on the Couch. We just kind of talk about what's going on in our lives for the week.
You can find us in different social media platforms like Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.
And we have a website, which is twocrazyketos.com, and that's where you're going to find all of our different recipes. Now we do upload at least 5 new videos every single week, so make sure you subscribe to our channel.
And don't forget to hit the little bell icon, and that way every single time we upload a new video, you'll be alerted to it.
Yeah, we forgot to introduce our friend.
Well, he doesn't even deserve a name.
This is the devil scale.
Yes, it is. Some people have been affectionately calling him Scaly. And he's been in all kinds of little conundrums this week, right?
Yeah, so if you're new to our channel, this month we're doing a community-wide challenge, right?
Yeah.
It's called No Way November.
And I have to say, it's the toughest challenge that I have done yet.
I hate it.
And we have gone like a week of just eating nothing but eggs, right?
I cheated though.
Did you get on the scale?
Well, the rule was like No Way November, like we weren't allowed to get on the devil scale, right?
Yeah.
I went to Publix and got on the Publix scale.
Dog, then you totally cheated, yo.
Yeah, but I did it fully clothed with my keys and my wallet. So does that still count?
It counts.
But it's not like a true measurement because I don't know about you guys. I never get on the scale with clothes. Not even socks. Like socks weigh too much to get on the scale.
Well, I would just like to say on behalf of our family, like thank you for not stripping it down at Publix and publicly weighing.
This has been difficult because I like to get on the scale like 5 or 6 times a day.
Obviously, so because I don't think you've ever cheated on a challenge before. So this is admittedly difficult.
It is very difficult.
I don't think if I hadn't painted his face, I probably would have stepped on him too.
The only reason I haven't stepped on this scale is because I figured you were going to know that I stepped on it because you keep putting paint all over it.
Yeah. Well, let's move him because I don't even want to hold him.
So we're doing No Way November.
Mm-hmm.
And so the challenge is don't get on the scale. Instead, measure your success this month with measurements, with using tape measures, using pictures, and just trusting that if you do the right thing, you're going to have a good result at the end of the month.
And that has been the key.
Yeah.
Right? So I'm trying to only eat when I'm supposed to eat. If I want snacks, I'm trying to put them all together at mealtime because I'm also kind of observing, what is it, No Snack November. That's what Keto Chow is doing.
Yep.
And then also, no excuses. That's why I'm not getting on the scale because, like, watch Autumn Keto, no excuses November, right? So it's all kind of working together.
And see, I'm not personally anticipating measurements going down because we're still eating at a much higher a caloric threshold than we're used to. Mm-hmm. And at the end of this month, we're going to start going down.
Yeah.
But I am testing a couple other theories. So those other theories might possibly affect my measurements going in the reverse as well.
Well, I did start measuring and I will be posting my measurements every single week in our Facebook family group. If you haven't joined that yet, it's free to join.
Yep. There's a link down below in the description.
And I was pleasantly surprised. I did go down, but just like it's is always the case, especially with girls, you can't decide where the measurement, like where
nope.
the inches come off.
Nope.
So I just like to say, congratulations, my boobs got smaller this week.
You're telling me congratulations. I figured they got bigger.
No, they got smaller because I lost weight, but you don't get to decide where the weight comes off. I also went down like, I don't know, like 1/4 inch in my neck. Like I really
That's
needed.
That's awesome.
Well, like I really needed that though. But like, you know, your butt will stay about the same. But then, yeah, you lose neck inches or boob inches.
I did do some measurements myself, and I lost about 1 inch in my neck.
Okay.
But my waist says it's down 1/2 inch.
Uh huh.
But my pants are saying no, it's not.
Aw.
So I want to say that maybe the pants got washed in hot water, but that would be kind of falling into like Autumn's no excuses thing. And
right.
Like I'm using an excuse, but it makes no sense that my pants are tighter around the waist, but the measurement is almost 1 inch smaller.
So a funny thing for me is because I can't get on the scale and confirm, yes, we're headed in the right direction or no, we're not, right?
Mm-hmm.
I have diligently exercised every single day this week.
I was super proud of you.
No matter what the obstacle, usually if like a minor wrench gets thrown into the plans, I'm like, okay, yeah, there's my excuse to like not do this because I hate exercise, as we well know. I got a flat tire on my bicycle.
I fixed that.
Which you did fix.
Which was really weird though.
Did you fix my brakes?
I know, I need to order a part for the brakes, but you can still stop. But what was really weird about her bicycle tires, she said it was flat. I went out and I'm like, okay, maybe, you know, we had a couple of days of a little bit chillier temperature, chillier meaning like it was mid 70s.
Not 100.
So I was like, okay, let me fill it up. And of course, I go back out the next day, flat again. So I ran to Walmart, was on our vlog the other day. If you didn't see that, I'll leave a link over Rachel's head for that full day of eating. Got her a new tire, and I got one that has the slime in it. So if you would happen to run over, like, we have, like, lots of bushes and stuff down here that have, like, rose kind of thorns. Like,
oh,
they're
yeah.
called bougainvilleas. So I was like, maybe you ran something over
we call
like
them
that,
the devil
right?
plant.
Change out the tire tube, take the new tube, and it still had air in it. So I filled the tube up. It sat for 4 days, never lost any air.
So it's
so
like,
there was nothing wrong with the tire that was in there, except for every time I filled it up inside of the bicycle, it went flat. So I don't know if maybe this, like the little needle was bad. It was just really weird that you didn't actually have a flat tire.
I think that it was just like trying to make an excuse for me not to exercise, but I didn't take the easy excuse. I actually just was like, you know what? I'm putting my sneakers on and we'll just walk 4 miles.
Mm-hmm.
And then we had one day where it was raining. And I thought, okay, well, here's another excuse. I can't go out now because it's raining. And I thought, no, there's a local shopping center that I know has awnings over the whole length of it.
Right.
I'm just going to go there and walk back and forth down this shopping center. And I won't get wet, but I'm going to get my miles in. And I think if you are just determined, like, I'm doing this, that moment that you decide for yourself, I'm doing this. And no one else is choosing it for me. Because if you try to make me do, that doesn't work. It was like trying to potty train Caleb, like when it was a month before he was ready. A month before a child is ready to potty train, forget it.
Don't try it.
Just don't even bother. It's like a total uphill battle. But when they're ready, it's like easy, cheesy, lemon squeezy. So same for this. When I'm ready and it's on me and I want to do this, nothing can stop me.
Speaking of Caleb... It's actually, I want to talk about Anthony.
Yeah.
So we did the unboxing for the keto crate the other day, and we were talking about how, like, when Anthony took the pictures of us holding the keto crate, and he saw the strawberry lime peanut butter
yes.
in there, or the nut butter in there, and he claimed it,
mm-hmm.
and we'd said it in that opening. One of our subscribers, I don't remember who it was, said, hey, wait a second. You guys have been trying to get Anthony to do keto for like a week or a month, and he won't. So
yeah.
Anthony should be banned from all keto snacks.
That sounds like a Joe response.
It was not my response. It was one of our subscribers said, why should he get such a delicious keto treat if he's not willing to try keto?
But doesn't that sound like you?
It does sound like me.
I mean, absolutely. Like, hey, yeah.
They try to do it now. They'll try to eat our ice cream. I'm like, no, you're not doing keto. You're not getting that delicious ice cream.
But
like, go buy your own garbage ice cream or go back on keto.
Well, even Caleb said, he's like, there's a huge difference.
Yeah.
Because it's very rich. It's very like, I don't know, the ingredients taste super fresh. Like if there's nuts or something in it, it just tastes like a higher level ice cream.
Right. Well, I also don't want, I sound like a monster, but I also don't want to contribute to any issues they could have because they are eating some carbohydrates, especially with dinner. And when do you want to eat ice cream, like with dinner or right after dinner? And I talk about this all the time. It's not so much that carbohydrates, like good carbohydrates,
right.
I mean vegetable carbohydrates. I'm
like
not talking about
ice cream
eating
ones.
Sugar or potato chips, that
yeah.
kind of stuff. But you know, if you are, it's not that they're completely bad, but you don't want to mix them with fat. And the last thing I want to do is have my kids eat a high carbohydrate dinner and then give them a 90% fat dessert.
Yeah.
You know, so you got to find that balance. You never want to eat your carbohydrates with your fat. That's the whole issue. So that's why people who do something like the, plant-based whole food diet,
yeah.
who they are eating carbohydrates,
they have great success.
Right? They have very similar success to what keto has as far as like diabetes and other issues, But what's the difference? They are eating carbohydrates in their plants. They're only eating plants.
Right.
They eat zero extra fats. The only fats they get is that there's fats within their vegetables, like an avocado. But they have no oil at all, no butter at all. So they're eating carbohydrates, but they're eating like no fat.
I admire their commitment to this.
I do.
But I am really glad that we're keto instead. If you're going to get similar results, I would rather be keto.
Yeah.
I feel like it's more flavorful.
Yeah. So I do think we're going to eventually get Anthony to at least try it. He's like right there. He just keeps saying, I like my sugar too much. But if we can keep finding more and more sugar treats or like sweet treats that are keto friendly.
Yeah.
You know, especially now with, I've been messing around with that allulose. And wow, that allulose, it's only 70% as sweet as sugar. But it's got none of those funny tastes that you get with stevia or the cooling effects with erythritol.
The peanut butter fudge.
Oh my gosh. We released that video today.
Which is Sunday.
And yeah, I had to hide it in the freezer because everybody just wants to eat that.
Everybody wants it. So that, and I will say that this week, because Caleb has started working and he was like needing to take lunch and stuff with him, he said to me this week, don't buy any more prepackaged garbage. He's like, I don't want to feel like junk. Let's get hamburger. Let's get broccoli. I just want to keep it.
Well, that's what I'm going to do this week. I actually bought the other day, I bought 6 pounds of ground beef at Costco. It was like $2.88. No, it wasn't grass fed, but it was a good deal. And it was higher protein and less fat. It was like, I think it was 90-10. And that's what I always say. If you are going to not buy grass-fed, don't buy the high-fat one. Don't buy 75-25 if you're not buying grass-fed, if you can afford it.
Yeah.
Because all of the antibiotics, the chemicals, and everything else is stored in the fat. So you want to buy a much leaner ground beef and then add your own fat.
Yeah.
So I bought that. And my intention was to do like a whole bunch of meal prep, make a meatloaf, make a taco pie, make all that stuff. And then we got so busy like on Thursday and Friday and then I'm going in the freezer. So that's going to come out. It's going to defrost tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to do a what to do with 6 pounds of ground beef thing. And we're going to make a bunch of different ground beef recipes that are great for meal prep, where you can just put them in little individual containers and he can grab them and go to work. But they're all going to be keto friendly so that we can eat them as well.
Yeah.
And what I like to do is stick like a little like thing, like just a little marker on the front saying like, this is 478 calories, so that you can enter it into Chronometer for yourself.
Right. And then just for them to have kind of a gauge.
Right.
You know, also, not that the boys are quite as concerned as like hitting their macros as we are, but it's interesting. And I thought that was cool that on his own, he came back and was just like, yeah, I don't want to feel junky anymore. And this is just garbage. And he was like, I think they've been studying more health stuff in school too. And
right.
He was like, I'm starting to understand what like these long laundry lists of ingredients and all of the chemicals. And he's like, I just don't want that in my life. So it's kind of interesting.
Yeah. And that's the thing is, I mean, things like corn dogs and all those breakfast sandwiches, they're super convenient.
Yeah, absolutely.
But they're loaded with chemicals. They're loaded with preservatives. And you can really just accomplish the same thing with just maybe 30 minutes to an hour of meal prep at the beginning of the week.
It's worth the time.
So, like, football season is officially over. Did my last set of games yesterday. So I'm going to have some more time to do some of that stuff. And we're going to get back into the meal prepping even for them. And I do have lacrosse games next week, though. I have 2 lacrosse tournaments before the end of the year. Then you have me pretty much for the whole month of December, the whole month of January, and then half of February. And then it starts all over again.
The funny thing is that, like, if you have a husband or a wife that has this kind of schedule where you're gone, you're out of the picture for certain days
of the
week.
I'm drinking grape Zip Fizz, and I can't stop drinking it.
Grape?
Well, somebody drank the last Limon.
It wasn't me. I did leave. I know there was at least one when I was drinking them. I moved on to fruit punch at this point.
Okay, sorry.
But yeah.
Excuse me.
But I have to reacclimate to having you around every day. It's kind of like if someone's like a truck driver or an accountant and, you know, like you have a season that you're just gone. You're just kind of, I'm used to like Friday nights, like
not being home,
doing my own thing. And so like, yeah, I have to get used to like Joe's here.
Sports officiating is kind of weird, especially when you do a couple of different sports, because you know, for me, from my mindset too, it's like you get super excited about it at the beginning of the season, and then those last couple of weeks of the season, you're like, oh, when is this going to be over? I'm just ready for it to be over. But you go, 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 and then all of a sudden it's like you have nothing. Right. And it's like that in football, but lacrosse is even worse. When lacrosse season starts up mid-February, and I work like 10 to 15 games a week, in those last couple of weeks of the season, you're like, I wish I could just give this game back. I'm tired.
You're tired of going.
But you really do go from like every single day doing something to all of a sudden like, now what do I do with my life?
And it's very weird at the house.
And yeah, so it definitely gets on. Rachel's like, don't you have a game? For the last week, she's been going, don't you have a game today? I'm like, no.
Well, because, you know, for a while, I have complete control over the clicker. And it's all me. I get to decide like what I'm watching on a Friday night, and all of a sudden now I have to share the clicker.
Yeah, so I hope you've gotten your fill of your Korean dramas. You've been watching Chinese dramas.
I have been watching some Chinese dramas.
Those are gone for a while. It's time to find some stuff to watch together.
No.
I might have some time to watch some Korean dramas now. It's just, again, she would be like,
you heard it here. He's promising
I like Korean dramas.
They're
but
good.
She was like, I really wish you would watch this one with me. I'm like, I have like 30 minutes. I really, the only time I'm watching TV is when I'm falling asleep or if I'm eating. I don't have enough time to watch like and have to read the subtitles. And I certainly am not going to do it while I'm eating.
Well, a big difference between the K-dramas that we usually watch, like through the Viki,
right,
you know, app, usually it's like 16 to 20 episodes. Some of the Chinese dramas that I've been watching, 50 episodes.
I don't want to watch the Chinese dramas. I like the Korean dramas.
50 episodes.
I'm definitely not watching a 50 episode show.
Like, that's a commitment. I mean,
does anybody else watch Korean dramas? I mean, like, we watch Boys Over Flowers, Full House. I mean, there's so many. I mean, too many to even name, but I'm curious.
Who's my besties out there?
Is there anybody else that subscribes to us that watches Korean dramas? Let us know. And if you do watch Korean dramas, what is your favorite one? Let us know down below.
And if you do watch Korean dramas, I'm coming to your house because, like, so I have somebody else to watch it with.
So let's talk about the rest of our week. So we had, it was pretty quiet. I mean, we had a bunch of civil work. Mm-hmm. Food-wise was kind of full. We made a brisket the other day. So we've been eating brisket for 4 days. I have a little bit left. What I like to do with the brisket is then heat it up, chop it up, and then mix it in with eggs. Like, instead of having corned beef and eggs, I have brisket and eggs.
I mean, you have to stop for a minute and just appreciate the fact that we would have had to go to, like, a super fancy place to be like, oh, your omelet made with brisket.
Right.
You know, we had hamburger this past week topped with brisket. I mean, like, we're talking amazing level.
Oh, yeah. We got a hamburger because I had a coupon for, what's that place?
Tucker Duke's.
Because every once in a while, like, Groupon does, like, $15 for $30 worth. So we'll get a couple of those and treat ourselves. If you've ever been to Tucker Duke's, I know they have a few of them around the country.
Mm-hmm.
They have a burger called the Mondragon.
It's really good.
Which is a half-pound burger with 6 slices of bacon. It's got cheddar cheese and an egg on top.
And they cook it just right.
And they'll cook it. They cook it perfect. And just tell them no bread. It's their most keto-friendly one they have, because you can just say, like, no bun, and they'll put it on a nice bed of lettuce, and they put the sauce on the side.
It's wonderful.
It tastes great. So we had that. And then, yeah, we brought it home and said, like, hey, we need more calories. Let's put brisket on top of that. What else? Oh, I made
life
my taco
good.
Pie this week. I had a couple pounds of ground beef. That was like grass-fed ground beef. It was, what a difference using grass-fed ground beef in the taco pie.
So I got exactly one night of eating that, and then it was just gone. Because that's something that the boys like eating.
I ate 4 out of the 8 pieces.
Really? Well, the boys ate a bunch too.
Well, you had 2 pieces because I gave you a double portion that day.
Oh,
and
okay.
We put it on Instagram.
All right, so I'm blaming the kids, but it's you.
It was all me.
Oh, okay.
I think Caleb got 2 slices one day.
Okay.
Anthony went to grab it and he was like, what happened to it? I'm like, I hid the other 2 slices that were left in the outside refrigerator because I was like, I'm not sharing this.
That is sneaky.
I love that taco pie and it's super easy to make. I'll leave a link for the recipe down below. And
it keeps
really well.
I think
we have a video on it, but it keeps really well. Super easy to make though.
Yeah, and the kids have always liked it.
Yeah. So we did that. Like I said, I had my last set of youth football yesterday. We went to Costco. So I don't remember even what we went to Costco for. We needed some stuff for church. Oh, we needed stuff for church because we were doing this activity in church where the kids were. We talked about it last week where they had to share.
Yeah.
And the idea was every kid got a little bag of cookies, but only if one or two kids in the class
on their team
would give up their and say like, I won't have anything so that everybody else can have.
Yeah.
What they didn't know is if they did give it up, they got an entire package of cookies or cakes or something like that.
It's kind of terrible that we're perpetuating
this. It is, but well, they didn't have anything. Well, we went to Costco to see what could we find that we could give them. So anyway, we went there and Rachel finds this stuff.
Which I got super excited about.
I was super excited. It's a keto snack mix. Macadamias, pecans, pepitas, almonds, probiotic cheese balls. And I'm thinking, oh my gosh, it's like a keto farms except for no fruit in it.
But this is $12 and change a bag. It was like 50 cents a serving, which is awesome.
This is $12. And I said last week, I can't stop eating this stuff. And
there's nothing in that.
This stuff is $20 for three bags. And there's 3.5 servings in a bag. There's really 2 servings in
a
bag.
So I thought, well, this is cost effective.
Yeah.
So,
and what was it, like 15 bucks?
No, it was $12. $12.
Here's the thing. Okay, 24 servings in this bag, which is kind of dangerous because, yeah, right, you're just going to reach your hand in. I kind of like this, knowing if I eat the entire bag, I know exactly what I'm eating.
But, I mean, it's 50 cents a serving. So, yeah. I mean, I like the cost of it.
Yep. So, and a serving size is an ounce, 170 calories, 15 grams of fat, 7 grams of protein, 4 total carbohydrates, 2 grams of dietary fiber. So you're like, 2 net carbs, perfect. Fully compliant with keto diet guidelines.
You can go and grab it at Costco so you're not waiting for it to come
and
in the mail.
Take a look at that. So, it's disgusting.
Disgusting.
We went in the car.
So disgusting.
We opened it up. We were super excited. We were like, we're going to break our fast with this stuff. Like, I was excited.
I was excited.
Cheese balls, macadamia nuts. The cheese balls taste like dish detergent.
No, I'll tell you what it tastes like exactly. It tastes like canned green beans.
And the problem is,
why does it taste like canned green beans? I don't know.
The problem is the flavor from the cheese is all over the nuts. So even when you eat the pecans or the macadamia nuts,
canned green beans,
they all taste the same. And like, you dig through this entire bag, you can't even find a macadamia nut.
No,
it doesn't. It smells not fresh.
It was
do not buy this.
Disgusting.
We actually have this, and Costco does have a good return policy.
Yeah.
We are taking this back.
And we are not, I mean, we're not the type of people that are like, oh, we're going to eat it down to here
and then take it back.
No,
like we had that bite out of it, and we're like, yep, we're taking it back. But we were like, it was so not worth it. Do not buy this.
I was like, is there a filling in my teeth that's gone bad or something? Like, why does it taste like that?
So I'm back to my keto farms, and this is Rachel's favorite flavor. This is the sweet strawberry.
Although it's empty.
It is empty.
I have not eaten
it. I splurge on myself to have this. I actually saved you a serving. There's probably a little bit more than a serving, but you can have everything left in here. You're really going to be mad when you see this.
Okay.
So I'd gotten last month, they had a variety pack. Wait a second. They had a variety pack. So it came with one of these.
Okay.
And then the new bacon one.
I haven't tried that.
It's got, I'm upset because the bacon seasoning has melted dextrin, so I won't buy that flavor anymore.
Oh, okay.
It's not their fault. It's just that the powder that they're using has melted dextrin. And then the new jalapeno one.
Yeah, which is good.
They've redone the strawberry one.
Really?
Yeah. You know how you always had those little tiny flakes?
Yeah. And you ate the whole bag?
Look at the size of the strawberries that come in Keto Farms now.
Oh,
it's like a half a strawberry.
You are a stinker. I cannot believe you ate this.
So you can have, there's probably about a serving left. So you can have that serving. I'll get you some more.
You better.
I can't stop eating Keto Farms. It is so good.
Oh my God.
I'll leave a link for it down below. We're not affiliated with them. They're just, I mean, first of all, they're awesome guys. But
oh my gosh, that strawberry.
They've like reformulated it. The new jalapeno flavor, which is incredible, but the strawberry in that.
Oh my goodness.
Is so good.
So here's the thing. The strawberry is perfect like a strawberry should.
Mm-hmm.
How many times have you brought a strawberry or a blueberry and you bite it and you're like, this is going to be awesome. It looks awesome. Right. And then you better.
I was going to read the nutrition. Like, finish talking.
And then you bite it and you're like, it's like sour or it's just like a, especially sometimes we get from Aldi's.
Yeah. Now what's nice about these is they're dehydrated.
You have to almost eat some of their produce in the parking lot.
Yeah. So if you're new to our channel, if you've never tried these, and again, we're not affiliated with this company at all. There's 3.5 servings in here. I honestly probably, I do get 3.5 servings out of it.
You're just eating them all at the same time.
No, usually I get 3.5 servings over the course of 2 days.
Okay.
So it's like I'll have a little bit and then I'll have a little bit a few hours later. And then I'm like, oh my gosh, I finished that bag. So anyway, 170 calories per serving, 13 grams of fat, 7 grams of protein, 5 total carbohydrates, 2 grams of dietary fiber. So it's 3 net carbs. But again, you've got strawberries, and they have a few different flavors. This
and
is
nuts.
Just a nice sweet flavor. There's a raspberry Gouda one, right? And then there's the jalapeno one is like, my favorite one is the jalapeno one. You can have the rest. Before you move into comments, we have mail.
Just strawberries. Okay. First of all, we went to church today, and Caesar and Monica, they're in our Facebook family group. We love their family. I love their kiddos. Got guacking around the Christmas tree
that
ornament.
That is so awesome.
How cute is that? And on the back, she actually drew our logo. I don't know if you can see it, but it says 2KK. Is that cute?
There you go.
How adorable is that? Thank you so much.
It's focusing on our face.
Caesar and Monica. Love their family so much.
That is so pretty.
You guys are awesome.
Yep.
And let's see. We got some mail from Miss Cheryl, who had given us beef sticks.
Oh my gosh, Cheryl.
Before.
I could not believe you.
And she got you more of the
beef
sticks.
She sent us those 2 beef sticks to try and then sent me a thing after we said we liked them. She was like, here, because our Costco doesn't have them.
Miss Cheryl, you are a doll.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
And then she got this beautiful ornament that says keto checklist, bacon, butter, avocado, coffee, and it's all checked off.
I gotta get it up closer so it focuses.
My arms aren't as long. This is so stinking cute. I absolutely love this. And this actually is, like, this looks a lot like my shopping list.
So if you're new to our channel on what date? December 5th, right?
December 5th.
December 5th. We're going to
the day before your birthday.
Yeah, we're going to decorate our Christmas tree, and it will only be decorated with
ornaments
that you guys have sent us. So our address is down below. You feel free to send us an ornament. It could be a handmade thing. It could be something your grandchildren drew.
We're going to start making them in Coastal Kids.
Yeah, so that's it. That's the only thing that's going to be on there. So we're looking forward to it. So we're going to decorate the tree live on December 5th. I don't know what time yet. We'll figure that one out a little
later. Probably 7.
So we're going to decorate it live. We're going to try to get Rachel to sing because she's an incredible singer, but she never wants to sing in front of people. And we're going to celebrate my birthday.
Yes.
Right, because my birthday is the next day.
You're gonna be 49.
49. I don't feel 49. Do I look 49?
No.
Do I look 49? Please be kind. Don't say, no, you look 69, something like that.
That's awful. And another heads up for December, the first 12 days of December, we will be jumping on to go live every single day. Oh, Tabitha's playing. For the 12 giveaways of Christmas.
Yeah, and it's not going to be a long live. It's going to be like maybe 10, 15 minutes tops.
Just long enough to give some stuff away.
To give something away. Roscoe's on his way up to visit.
Hey, Roscoe.
And, I haven't even looked at it, but we got the Aldi's Advent Cheese Calendar.
Yes.
Is that supposed to start on a certain day?
Well, I mean, probably December 1st I would do it.
Okay.
Right, wouldn't you?
I didn't
you?
Look. Is there an expiration date on it?
No, I don't think so. I mean, we'll look.
So we each got one, so every day we're going to eat like a piece of that.
Okay, this was hilarious though. I kind of got a little sticker shock because they were $15 a piece and I'm not used to spending like $30 at Aldi's. Are you? Like for $30 at Aldi's, like it usually goes like a long way. So
for
me to be like, oh, 2 items and it'd be $30, I was like, what? What happened? But it makes sense.
Yeah.
It's fancy cheese.
You ready to do some comments?
Yes, please.
Okay. So we have some comments. We have a couple subscriber of the week.
Roscoe's just sitting there judging us.
Okay. Yeah.
He's just like, want to come over here?
Roscoe, over. You're say never hi, in the videos.
Say hi.
Roscoe.
Say hi, everybody.
That's all you have to do. Yeah. Come here, Roscoe.
We've got a little language going on.
Okay, so our first subscriber of the week is Erica.
Hi, Erica.
I'm going to put Erica's pictures. I don't know why I point up here. It's right here. Okay, so Erica wrote, so I've been at keto off and on since January of 2019. My son went in the hospital. I got off track. Since August, I found Two Crazy Ketos video, and it motivated me to get back on. And serious with the Keto Chow Challenge. I started in January around 340-ish, probably. I didn't weigh. After losing a lot, I did, and I was 321.
Wow.
I started in August around 323, and now I'm 294.
Wow.
Still have a bunch to go, but I feel great, and I stick on keto in hospital. So thank you for all your tips and your tricks and yummy recipes that even my boys eat. Between your videos and my faith, I know I can get where I need to be again. August is the flower dress of, I was a 24-26, mm-hmm. and Saturday I tried on a 16-18.
Ooh, look, it's you. Oh my goodness, you are absolutely gorgeous. Wow, congratulations.
Congratulations, Erica. You look incredible. Keep it up.
I love that polka dot.
Yeah.
Wow, you look amazing.
Okay, so the next one is Jerry.
Hey, Jerry.
And Jerry, I'm going to put his pictures right here.
And Uncle Jerry.
He wrote, good morning, keto family. I just wanted to post a before and after photo during my keto journey. The pic on the left was my carb face and the picture that convinced me that I need to make a change in my life. I was the heaviest I've ever been at 247 pounds, and that was in January of this year. The pic on the right was taken on Halloween. I'm 172 pounds now.
Wow, Jerry.
My goal weight was 175 and I reached that in August. I've been maintaining now for about 3 months or minus a couple of pounds, high or low. I find it much harder to maintain the weight than it was to take it off. I never could really see a difference until I saw side by side of before and after. So definitely take pictures and capture your journey. Stay keto strong.
Yes, let me see. Oh my gracious, Jerry.
That's sometimes still now the only way I notice a difference. Because I look at myself in the mirror and I still see the fat guy. I do.
Well, I like what Jerry said about sometimes it's harder to maintain.
Yeah.
And it is. And there is a lot of, let me see, I get kind of sad sometimes because when you're losing, when I started out and it was like 255 pounds, you felt like you were constantly having some kind of celebration. You would lose like 5 pounds or 2 pounds or 3 pounds, or there'd be an inch off or something like that. But finally you get to your goal weight or where you kind of plateau, and all of a sudden you don't have that like daily or weekly like celebration. But we really should,
right?
Because it's like, I could wake up today and be like, wow, I can have a celebration that it's been this many days since I've lost 100 pounds. Right. I mean, it's still an amazing thing to have happen. But yeah, sometimes at that maintenance mode, that can be the most difficult.
And I think it's difficult, in my opinion, is for a couple of reasons. Number one, finding that the threshold of mm-hmm. what is maintenance without going up. And I think that's hard because your activity level changes, especially, at least for me, it's hard because I have months where I'm super active mm-hmm. and then I have months where I'm not active. Like you take me in April, in February, March, and April, and I'm running 15, 20 miles a day sometimes yeah. on lacrosse games, and I've eaten upwards of 6,000-7,000 calories in a day, and I would still drop weight. And then all of a sudden come the end of April and May, and now I'm like not active
done.
At all.
Right.
And I drop my calories to like 2,000 and I start gaining weight because my body got so used to that like high activity level. Mm-hmm. So, you know, because your activity level is changing, even like say weekday to weekend, yeah. you know, it's hard to find that proper caloric threshold. And then to top it off is, I think we have a mental thing, especially if you're someone like us who was heavy.
Yeah.
And you're so terrified. At least I know I am that I'm going to put that weight back on.
Yes.
And so it starts becoming a mind game, like, oh my gosh, I'm up a half a pound. What am I doing wrong? And then you start messing with your diet more instead of just like not worrying about it and figuring like, hey, it's probably water. It's probably like the way the earth is cycling. But we get so focused on that fear.
Yes.
That the devil scale is going to like go up again, and we don't ever want to go back to where we are.
Yeah.
Or we were.
Yeah, definitely. That's definitely a struggle for me.
Okay, so comments. Keto Heather wrote,
hey, Keto Heather.
I wish we would have some nutrition labels like they do in Europe, where they use 100 grams for a serving size for all products. It makes it easy to compare different foods.
Wow, yes.
That's, I really do feel like the United States needs to do something with the nutrition label. Either make it like the nutrition label has to be the entire package, like whatever's in the package, that's what's on the label, instead of this, you know, I love Keto Farms, but 3.5 servings, really? Who's eating a half a serving?
Not me.
Just tell me it's 3 servings or it's 4 servings.
Yeah.
You know, one or the other. But I like that. Every serving size is the same, because that's what they do, is they manipulate the serving size so that they can fit in the right calories. Like those 100 calories, remember the 100 calorie packs?
Oh my Lord.
What do they do? You just get less cookies.
Exactly.
There's no difference between eating 100 calorie pack of Oreos or eating 2 Oreos. What's the difference? I think it's actually 1 Oreo.
Well, and the whole thought process was, well, if we put it in a bag, then you're only going to eat the one. Not Rachel.
Nope.
I would just be like, I'm opening up the box and now I'll just eat 3 packages of 100 calorie food. So it totally defeated the whole purpose. And I paid double for it.
Yeah. Danny wrote,
hey, Danny.
Could you guys do a review on the Smoothie King's 2 Keto Champs drinks? We've thought about it.
We have.
And I know that Keto Connected did one. I believe Goody Beats did one. And I've thought about it. I was never a smoothie person to begin with. I mean, years ago, I would get them when I went to the gym.
Because
I didn't know what
Jamba
Juice. I was doing. Yeah. I didn't know what I was doing back then, realizing, like, I thought I was eating healthy, like I think most people do.
Yeah.
My problem is their keto versions are like 7 and 10 net carbs. And I just don't know if, I love you guys, but don't know if I want to drink a 7 net carb drink. That's a net carb drink.
Yeah, and I don't know like how often I would even get something.
We might get one of them and split it.
There you go.
But
let's do that.
I can tell you, just based on the fact that it's 7 net carbs, I probably would never recommend it to somebody at 7 net carbs.
So maybe we'll get one and split it.
Yeah. So Ellen wrote,
hey, Ellen.
How do you guys like your Crocs? I just ordered a pair of Lion Crocs for my collection because they now have leopard prints. I just love animal print. She also wrote, I can't find the 0 net carb bread either, so I'm in search of a recipe to make my own. Aldi's pork belly is delicious. Sadly, it's seasonal. I didn't know that. She said, like, I did like the marinated pork belly they had a few years ago much more.
Oh, wow. Okay, we never got that.
No, we didn't get that.
That sounds delicious.
Well, that was pre-keto days, probably.
Mm.
Never would have eaten pork belly.
But the pork belly was really
good.
It
was really good.
Crazy good.
How do we like our Crocs? Sadly, I actually like them.
I love them.
I hate the fact that we're going to admit that they still look stupid.
You think so?
They look stupid, but they are comfortable.
I think I look kind of cute in them.
And you do. You look cute in anything.
Well, and I like your sneakers.
The sneakers, like, oh my gosh, the sneakers are ridiculously comfortable. Just they make squeaky noises when I walk down the hall at church.
They do squeak.
But they're super comfortable. But I am really enjoying the slip-on Crocs, and I got a pair of the Line ones too. I got the Line ones and a regular one.
Mm-hmm.
And I hate to say this, but I may go back and get another pair of Crocs.
I actually was, when I was walking in that strip mall and I saw there was like a shoe store in there and they had like a display of like new Crocs coming out. And I actually saw those animal print ones that she's talking about. And I was like, ooh, they had a whole bunch of different ones.
The one I'm surprised that you haven't bought yet is the American flag ones, where one is like stripes and the other one is stars. Have you seen that one? It's the 2 different shoes, and one's blue and one's red and white.
Those are really, really cute. And there was one that was kind of like a faded, like with different colors, like rainbow colors or something. And I thought that one was super cute.
Yeah, so I got my regular ones that Anthony says aren't real Crocs because they don't have the same holes, but they are Crocs. They're a little big on me, but again, we kind of got them as a joke, not thinking I was going to like them, and they were the only thing that was clearance. So if I find something like cheap, I'll get like the size that actually fits me. I'm still wearing them and stuff, yeah. But they are a little bit big.
They're super comfy.
But they are very comfortable. I hate to admit that, but they are. Linda wrote,
"Hey Linda,
the zero carb bread is not coming back anytime soon. I called them and I asked."
Well, I'm glad that somebody got like a decision from them, because like, yeah, we've been searching and searching, right, and haven't found them anywhere.
And we're really looking for it more as a review, because I don't miss a lot of bread. And when I do feel like having a bread, it's usually only on a burger. And we just use the smart buns.
And we don't just have one Aldi's. We've got like four
in
within 20 minutes. And none of them have it.
Yeah. Cheryl wrote,
"Hey Cheryl,
I bought the pork belly as well. I cooked it in the air fryer and it was delicious." Yes.
We should have put it in the air fryer.
Well, we have another piece left. I was going to make that today and with wings. Yes. We're having pork belly and wings for lunch and dinner.
Are you serious?
Well, the wings are high protein. The pork belly will bring up the fat.
Well, that's our video for today. No, just kidding.
David wrote,
"Hey David,
we had snow on Halloween. It was crazy. We got 4 inches of snow, so we only had 5 trick-or-treaters. Now the candy is staring at me. I've got to put it away or else."
Man, I am so Jello Jigglers over the fact that they have snow.
Somebody came up to me to church today and they were like, "Oh, look, it's autumn." I'm like, it's 77 degrees outside.
Hey,
this isn't autumn. It was 72 yesterday.
We'll take every degree lower that we have.
So I'm like, yeah, I pray for the days where it's just like in the high 60s. We get like 5 or 6 of them a year and we can open up the windows and stuff and get the cool air coming in from the outside instead of the air conditioning. Plus my air conditioning bill goes down for a couple of days. He's like, "I just want like 5 feet of snow." And I'm like, "You're not getting that in Florida."
Sadly, no.
Cheryl wrote,
"Hey, Cheryl.
Fat, nasty, full. I have never heard of that expression before. I love it."
Man, only somebody who can eat as much as I can eat in a sitting can really, really feel that fat, nasty, full.
Lisa wrote,
"Hey Lisa.
First, Joe, I have a Contigo. I love it. I can put ice in it and it stays cold all day." Yes, they're awesome.
I love Contigo.
"Second, I too enjoy giving gifts more than receiving, and I'm always the last one to open gifts, as to my biggest joy is seeing the faces of the ones that I love most when they open their gifts. Third, Rachel, do not change. I love your bubbly expressions and your reactions to your gifts. I love watching you both. Thank you both for all of you do."
Oh my goodness. Well, thank you. Wow.
So Maximum wrote,
"Hey Maximum.
Oh boy, not me. I love getting my gifts. If possible, I like getting them early, LOL." "I love the remarriage tale."
Oh, well, thank you, Maximum. Yeah, if you want gifts early, have Joe give them gifts.
I cannot buy gifts and hold them. My whole thing is, as soon as I get them, like, Rachel doesn't even have to go snooping, because, like, she'll just look at me funny and be like, "Can I give you your present now? I know Christmas isn't for, like, 3 more months."
And I'm like, no, on Christmas morning, I'm going to get nothing.
Bambi wrote,
"Hey, Bambi.
See, when you shy away from opening your gifts in front of the giver, you're trying to deny them the joy that you have in watching them open theirs for you."
Yes.
That's what I think of.
Seriously.
I know she's right, but it's still... Yeah, you're right, because like, I would not enjoy giving a gift.
And if I'm like,
if I don't get to see like you cry.
Yes, I want to see you cry. Let's make Joe cry, guys.
So Paul wrote,
"Hey Paul,
I forgot about the time change. I started losing my mind. Grabbed my phone to tell everyone I was going to be late to church, and my phone saved me."
Oh man, yes. Like there's a panic. There's a panic, especially
when you see one like that's wrong. Rachel wrote,
"Hey Rachel,
I change all my clocks and watch before I go to bed for daylight savings, so I don't wake up freaked out all the time, already being disoriented.
Brilliant.
I love your gifts. They were so cool. I love seeing a clip of your second wedding. Rachel was truly surprised."
Oh man. If you couldn't tell by like, what octave was I even in? It was like, oh my gosh. Like crazy.
My dad used to do that. He religiously went around the house and changed all the clocks before he went to bed. Of course, back then you didn't have like cell phones and stuff like that.
And weren't you like, this is when you were a child, right?
Well, yeah.
So sundials.
Nice. Lisa wrote,
"Hey Lisa.
Hi guys. My husband resets the clocks in the house. I do the one in the car, but I forget to do the ones in the house. Rachel, you are so funny about your leg hair."
Oh, it's so bad. It's really, really bad. Now you've, after we did our photos, I see that now you're rocking the Santa beard already.
I am. I'm still shaving my head, but not my face. I am doing my neck. I can't stand neck hair. So, like, I'm just going to, like, let all of this fill in, but I cannot stand neck hair.
Are you worried that it's going to be whiter than past years?
So long as I don't have to go buy a car, which I do. I have to go take our kids to buy cars. So long as I don't, like, have to go buy a car, my beard shouldn't turn white.
When he went car shopping for our oldest child, his beard turned completely white.
In 3 hours.
I think it was just the absolute fear of, oh my goodness, I need to get this car to be safe.
Well, I got to find a safe car. Now I got to do it 2 more times. But I got to find a safe car that's reliable at a budget price. Like, we're trying to stay, like, under $4,000. But I don't want it to have, like, more than, like, 75,000 miles. And God has always blessed us with good cars. The first one that we found for John Paul, of course, somebody decided to set on fire in our driveway.
Yeah.
Fortunately, it was parked on the swale, not in the driveway, so our house didn't catch on fire.
But there was 3 other cars in the neighborhood that got burnt.
And then we were really blessed because the insurance company gave us more money for that car than we paid for it.
Yeah.
Then came going to buy the next car. And we went to buy the next car, and we found a great deal. It was, I don't even remember what it was. It was like a Chrysler, right? Mm-hmm. It was some kind of a Chrysler. Like,
yeah.
But it was at a Lexus dealership. So the Lexus was like, we want this off our lot. This does not look good with this Chrysler sitting on our lot.
Because it was a nice car.
Right. It was like an M300 or something like that. And so we got it a great deal, but they wanted to charge me like this $750 dealer fee. And I'm like, well, that wasn't in the listing. They're like, no, we paid dealer fee. I'm like, I'm not paying a dealer fee. I'm just not. And I'm getting up to walk out, and they're like, no. And so we're going back and forth. They're like, well, what do you want to pay? I'm like, I want to pay $4,000 out the door. Like, tag everything. $4,000, I'm not paying anymore. So back and forth. This is when my beard turns white. Back and forth, they finally come back. They're like, okay, here's the deal. We have to win. We have to win this argument. So we will sell it to you for $4,000 and one penny.
Just so that they were...
So they could win. I'm like, fine. You can have your penny.
It's so funny. So some people would say that their fear is frogs or snakes or spiders. Joe is the little side room they take you into when you're purchasing
a car. The confession booth.
Yeah. It's so bad.
I hope nobody's a car dealer out there.
Sorry.
And if you are, do you know any car dealers that can find me a couple of good used cars in South Florida? Okay. So Rachel wrote.
Hey, Rachel.
I reset everything on Saturday night before I go to bed. You all are adorable.
Brilliant.
Mai wrote.
Hey, Mai.
Daylight savings time happened? Wait, when? All my days blur together lately.
Aww.
I've been working 5 to 6 12-hour shifts lately.
Oh, my gracious.
I just glance at the calendar and holy poop, it's November.
Oh, that is awesome.
Seems like all my clocks fix themselves. I'm glad you guys filmed Keto on the Couch. I can wear my 2KK t-shirt and drink a fat coffee while I watch.
Oh, my. I love that. Oh, my goodness.
Debbie wrote.
Hey, Debbie.
I use my phone for alarm, so it sets automatically. My car was never reset from before, so now it's correct. That's how mine was. The next day is when I reset the stove and the microwave. She also said, I had less trick-or-treaters. It was extremely cold out, but the kids were so cute.
Aw.
So Gail wrote,
hey Gail,
I always change my clocks on Saturday morning, starting with the clocks in the bedroom, because that's the one that counts so that I'm not late for worship on Sunday.
Aww.
Then I go through and I change the rest, including the watches and even the car. I never register the time on the microwave anymore because I get power surges a lot, and that one I just leave blank. FYI, at Popeyes, you can get blackened tenders.
Oh.
Okay, so first of all, that would probably drive me insane changing the clocks on Saturday because now I'm going to go through all Saturday thinking it's the wrong time.
Aww. Well, maybe just change them and go right to bed.
Yeah. Well, she's changed them Saturday morning. So, wow, like, you are devoted.
Man, that is awesome.
So she mentioned Popeyes. The other day I'm at work and Anthony found out, oh, yes, Popeyes got that chicken sandwich thing again, right?
Yeah, but it was
and so he was like,
problems.
Dad, can you take me to Popeyes? I'm like, fine, we'll go to Popeyes. Because somebody actually got shot over the Popeyes sandwich. So we go to Popeyes and we just pull up around the corner. And I'm like, there is no way. There were 50 cars online to go like into the drive-thru.
To purchase a chicken sandwich.
To purchase a chicken sandwich. So I'm like, if you want this, maybe nobody is going in the store. So I'm like, jump out of the car. I literally pulled over on a main, like, five-lane highway. Like, jump out, run in, and I'll go find somewhere. And there's people parked on the swales, on the sidewalks.
Because there's a chicken sandwich.
For a chicken sandwich. I went across the street. I parked at the gas station.
Is it, like, laced with cocaine or something?
I don't know. So he comes back finally after, like, 20 minutes. He's like, I got it. I got one of each kind, the spicy and the regular one. And he was like, but it's so ridiculous. Somebody ordered 25, and they should be limiting them, which I agree. Like, that's if you are have this much of a rush on chicken sandwiches, no, you should have a limit. Like, no more than, like, two per person or something.
I mean, maybe
like
you could put an order in the day before or something.
They're running out. They're selling out. So, like, how would you like to be the person behind the one that's ordering 20 chicken sandwiches? They're like, oh, we just sold this guy 20. You get none now.
Well, I just would start eating his food.
But Anthony was so excited about that chicken sandwich, and he comes home, and he goes, Dad, I hate to say this. I'm like, what? And he goes, these are better than Chick-fil-A.
That's like blasphemy, isn't it?
It sounds like blasphemy to me.
Right? Like that's, what do they call it? Like Jesus chicken or something?
Vita wrote,
hey Vita.
The car is always the first for me because it's the easiest. Then I wait a few days or a week and I change the oven and the microwave. That's kind of like us.
Well, my car one is kind of challenging. So I think it's more like the hardest one for me.
I can never remember how to change the car one. That's the problem.
You got to turn up the volume of the radio. You got to turn the windshield wipers on 3 times. You got to open the door 4 times. Like, it's a whole production.
Vita's like on par with us. She goes, then I wait a few more months for my wall clock, and sometimes I just never change it.
Okay, so here's something not related to the clocks, like setting the clocks. However, the week following daylight savings time, it gets dark so early that I am just like, what time is it? Is it midnight? Like, it's midnight. We should be in bed. And it's like 5.
I know. Well, I'm a night owl anyway, so I'm always up at night. So it's really weird for me. But what I can't stand is the morning. Because again, I don't usually go to bed until 2 or 3. And my body just wakes itself up. So I don't even use alarms to wake up, unlike somebody over here who has like 5 of them. And I just wake up when somehow my mind sees the light outside.
Oh, so if the light is...
And my eyes are closed, but like, I guess, I don't know if I can, my body can just feel the sun. And so like, yeah, I've been getting up at like 5:30 and I'm like, I don't want to be up yet.
Well, I feel like the whole day is shot because it's getting dark so much earlier. So I go to pick Caleb up from work and we run into Publix and I'm like, it's midnight. I'm sure of it. It's got to be midnight. And it's like, no, it's like 5:30.
It's 4:30. It's probably dark outside already.
Yeah.
Tara wrote,
hey Tara.
I never changed the clocks. Before I married my husband, none of the clocks were ever correct. He's my polar opposite and changes all the clocks immediately.
Well, there you go.
My car will have the wrong time until he drives it.
Aw, but I love that.
Yvette wrote,
hey Yvette.
I set the one in the bedroom before bed and all the others in the morning. My son loved to watch the garbage truck every week, so he would run to the window.
Aww.
What a great picture to treasure. Yeah, that kid was so cute.
He was so cute.
A pal wrote,
hey pal.
I have to have the clocks right. I will usually wait until 4 to 5 o'clock at night to change and go around and change all the clocks. I have 4 clocks to change, so it's not so bad. I hate the time changes and wish California would be able to stay on DST or regular time. We voted to stay on one time and it passed, but the federal government hasn't allowed us to change yet.
So weird.
I, like so many other folks, have great difficulties with the forced changing of the sleeping patterns for several weeks after the change, especially in the spring when
yes.
we lose an hour.
The
spring is worse.
Totally messes me up. I feel like, I mean, maybe I'm going crazy here, but I feel like it kind of induces some seasonal depression.
It's just statistically, people are more depressed. You have businesses, it's where everybody's always late to work.
There's a
lot of car accidents. There are actually more suicides at that time of the year. Like, it is time to get rid of the time change.
I agree.
So last one. Anne wrote,
hey, Anne.
The clocks. Stop the clock touching. We immediately set the microwave, the stove, and the schoolhouse clock on the kitchen wall. The cars get set when we use the cars. As for the dog's toy box, we have 2 dogs. Only one uses his toy box. The floor is covered with his Ranger's toys.
Seriously.
I've tried to teach him how to put them back, but it doesn't work. Ranger knows when we are getting ready to leave, and we find him in his house, his crate. He knows our patterns. Annabelle has to be told. She doesn't play with her toys, the same breed and the same mother, but total opposites. Your Tabitha's stories have us smiling because we can totally relate. We love you too.
Aw, we love you. And yeah, I mean, it's amazing the personalities of these animals. Yeah. It's the same thing with like the cats. They have their own personality and they are not bending for what makes us comfortable, right? Nope. But yeah, Tabitha, I was trying to vacuum yesterday. And it was just wall-to-wall toys. Just nothing but toys.
And as soon as you pick them up, she brings them back out. Now, they will sit on that floor all day, and she won't touch them. You pick it up, now she's playing with
it. She is highly insulted. Highly insulted if you try to put her toys away.
I was trying to get a video of her the other day. She was playing with the bird. So the bird was on the outside of his cage, just kind of hanging, and she went up. And it was like back and forth. She'd like snip in and the bird would come out and it would go back and forth, back and forth. I'm like, that bird is going to bite your nose.
Yeah.
And she's just back and forth and she's like barking at it and the bird is making noises back. It went on for like 10 minutes. But every time I would pick up my phone, they would stop.
They're so silly.
Well, that is this week's Keto on the Couch. Please do us a favor and leave some questions and comments down below for next week's Keto on the Couch.
Yes.
And again, if you aren't a member of our Facebook family group, please go join and leave your stories in there because your stories encourage other people.
And every Friday, you can see how much smaller my boobs are getting.
And also, don't forget that now on Thursdays, we are live streaming at 7 o'clock.
Yes.
Eastern time. We live stream for probably about an hour. We kind of talk about nonsense. We answer your questions.
And we have like giveaways.
That. So yeah, we sometimes we'll do giveaways on them. So make sure you tune in again, 7 o'clock. We will be doing it again this Thursday. Next Thursday, I think we can. But this Thursday, we definitely are.
Yeah, we have a church thing.
Then I think we're taking 2 Thursdays off because we have the church thing and then the following Thursday is Thanksgiving. Or maybe we will live stream on Thanksgiving because we do Thanksgiving on Wednesdays.
Yes.
So unless we're shopping.
We are consistently inconsistent.
Well, that is this week's Keto on the Couch. So please do us a favor and hit that like button down below.
Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the little bell icon. And that way, every single time we upload a new video, you'll be alerted to it.
Until next time.
Bye.